Today, we're going to talk about 5 things you need to know as a renter in Miami. You don't want to miss this. I'm Marcia Valenzuela, and I work with my husband, Ignacio Valenzuela, the Miami real estate top broker. We bring you the best tips to make your real estate transaction stress-free. So let's get started. The number one tip and foundation of everything is to hire the right professional realtor for you in this particular situation. Why is this so important? For renters in particular, we've seen so many horror stories. Your professional realtor needs to be experienced in rents in the area that you're looking for, because so many times the landlord is not up to date in their mortgage payments. So what does that mean to you as a renter? That means that you can get a knock on your door saying you need to get out because this house is now under foreclosure and belongs to the bank. You don't want to be in that situation. So you need a professional realtor. Make sure you ask them, hey, are you checking into whether or not the landlord is up to date with their mortgage payments? Make sure you're on top of that and on top of your realtor to make sure they do that. It's also important that the realtor check for you to find out if the property you're looking for is actually rentable. Sometimes there are certain areas in Miami that aren't rentable, so you need to make sure that you're not getting into a property that you need to move out of pretty soon, thus losing money. The other thing you need to do is make sure that the realtor knows exactly what you're looking for. Now, your good realtor will always ask you lots of questions. Location, exact location you're looking for. How far do you want to be from work? What pets do you have, if any? How many people are going to live in the property? Do you want a backyard? Do you like tile over carpet? Whatever it is, your realtor really needs to hone in on the right property for you so you're not wasting time looking at properties you don't really care for and they don't fit the bill. So make sure your realtor is on top of things and knows exactly what you want and protects your best interests. All right, so tip number 2, also very important, is to act timely. You want to start looking for your property no more than 30 days before you want to move in. Why? Because there's lots of renters in Miami. We all know Miami is an expensive place to live, very hard to buy a property in Miami, and it's getting harder because interest rates are going up. So it's you and 100 other people looking for that particular property, or even more. So you want to make sure that you act timely. The landlord is going to pick someone who's ready to move in. So if you start looking at properties, let's say 2 months before you want to move in, you find the right place and you ask the landlord, hey, can you wait for me for 2 months? The answer will always be no, because right behind you is a renter ready to move in within the next 30 days. So don't look for homes too soon. It'll break your heart because you'll find properties you love and the answer will be no as far as moving in. So make sure that you work with your realtor to see when's the exact time you should be looking for properties in that area that you love. The second thing is to make sure that you are reviewing the properties that your realtor is sending you by email in a quick manner. Your realtor sends those properties, you should be reviewing them immediately and asking your realtor to set up those appointments to go see those homes as soon as possible. Because since there are so many renters out there and they're ready and they're on top of things, you might be losing a home that you fall in love with because someone else is ready and saw the property just a day before you did. A lot of the good rental properties are on the market for 1 day. So as soon as that property comes out, you think you're in love with it, go ask your realtor to set up the appointment, go see that home as soon as possible, and be ready to put down the deposit. The other thing that you want to really be timely about is the fact that you need to get your documents in place. This is another thing that your realtor can really organize for you, have it all ready before you even walk into the door. So some of the documents that you're going to need that you can get ready is, number one, your pay stubs from work and the pay stubs of all the people who are going to be living with you who work. So get that ready. The background check for everybody who's 18 and over who's going to live in the home, and also proof of money in the bank. So get those bank statements. Make sure that your realtor has all of that organized, ready to be sent as soon as you fall in love with a home. Be the one who gets the house, not the one who's second or third in line, who then has their heart broken. Also, number three, review the lease agreement. This is so important. Many times you just sign, because it's just, you figure it's a, you know, regular lease agreement. Everybody signs the same thing. Not true. Your professional realtor will make sure that they're protecting you and your benefits. Many times you're signing a lease agreement and you don't know that you're liable for so many things. For example, are you responsible for certain repairs, or is your landlord? Are you responsible for pest control, lawn maintenance, changing the AC filters once a month, taking your money when you want to break the lease agreement? What's that all about? You want to make sure that not only do you know about these things, but that your realtor can negotiate these things for you and have some of those things knocked off to your benefit. Tip number four, have your professional realtor take pictures of your new home before you move in and create an inventory. What is this for? Many times this is overlooked, but you want to make sure you tell your realtor to get this done. Number one, the security deposit is something that the landlord can keep. They can keep the whole thing or part of it in order to make repairs, in order to fix stains in the carpet or paint somewhere. So your money is in place, and these are things that you want to make sure, if they were there before you moved in, you're not liable for them. The professional realtor knows exactly what to look for. Things like grout problems they can take pictures of, cracks in the foundation that maybe you become liable for because later down the road they crack tiles, broken baseboards, stains on walls and carpets. These are things the realtor will hone in on, take pictures of, create an inventory, and they'll send the landlord the inventory and they'll send you a copy as well. So even if you move out 5 years down the road, you have that inventory in place and your security deposit goes back to you. Okay, tip number five, create a good initial relationship with the landlord. This is not only good for peace of mind and peace in your life, but this is going to have you avoid legal problems. Why is that? Well, when you have a good relationship with the landlord, you can always work things out. And initially, this is difficult to establish because what's one of the first things you're going to do? With your landlord, you're going to negotiate the lease agreement. And this can cause some type of conflict from the beginning. And then guess what? You have a rocky relationship after that. So in order to avoid all of that, have your realtor negotiate, not you, because the realtor knows what to ask for and what not to ask for, how to ask for it, and the landlord's dealing directly with the realtor, not with you. So it's really important for you to establish this relationship at first and have your realtor be the facilitator and to really establish a good relationship between you and the landlord. That's key. And we have an actual bonus tip for you today, and that's to get renter's insurance. Yes, something that people don't know if they should get or what it's for, all of that. And I'm here to tell you that it's inexpensive, it's something that anybody can get, and it's going to protect you in the long run, and again, avoid conflict with the landlord and maybe even legal problems. What is renter's insurance? Renter's insurance will protect your property inside the home if there's anything that happens. For example, some electrical problem causes a fire, or there's some type of leakage from the roof or something like that that can damage your property. Renter's insurance can definitely protect you from this, and also it can protect you and your family if someone gets hurt inside the home. Now, how does this help you? Well, if something like that happens, you just run to your insurance company, get that taken care of. They will send you money and cover if it's covered, etc. But without it, what happens? You start fighting with your landlord for them to cover some of the damage, and you're going to be in a fight forever because no landlord wants to give up money because something was damaged in your home or somebody was hurt. So in order to avoid all of that, just get the inexpensive renter's insurance. It'll save you a lot of headache in the long run. And again, it's a good investment to make. So thank you for listening. As always, click on the subscribe button if you haven't yet. And you can find us everywhere on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, YouTube, podcasts. Just search for Miami Real Estate Top Broker. Until next time, we'll be bringing you the best tips to make your real estate transactions stress-free by putting you first. Always. Take care, everybody.